Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Season 4 Reloaded just rolled out on consoles and PC, and we're going to talk a little bit about the patch notes because there were some really interesting weapon changes that honestly I didn't see coming. I also want to talk about some of the bugs and glitches that have been fixed with this particular patch as well. Alongside this, we're going to do walkthroughs of the brand new Cheshire Park map, and of course, we're going to talk about pretty much everything else that came with this particular update. I think it's only fitting that we start with the weapon changes because some of these are pretty dang confusing. Let's start off with the stopping power field upgrade. Now, if you're using this, it will apply to headshots, which means you can get a one-shot headshot kill with the FAL and the Odin. I don't know how this is going to work in particular modes like Warzone, but I think it's going to be pretty badass to use this in multiplayer. Whether it's 6v6 or ground war, I love the Odin, I love the FAL, so being able to get a one-shot headshot with stopping power, that's going to be pretty dang cool. It's also going to apply to all other weapons as well, so stopping power just gets a buff across the board. The start ammo and the max ammo was adjusted for the M4 SOCOM rounds. They've also increased the max ammo and the start ammo of the CR56 AMAX M67 rounds, the SKS 10 round mag, the Striker 45 hollow point rounds, the SCAR default magazine, and the Odin default magazine. Both the SCAR and the Odin went from 20 round magazines to 25 round magazines for the default now. I like that they're showing the Odin some love. That's one of my favorite weapons in this game, and it's just getting better and better. And speaking of weapons getting better and better, let's talk about those snipers, because pretty much all of them ended up getting a huge buff. The AX50 got an increase to its damage range. The HDR is now a guaranteed one-hit kill to the lower torso at any range. That is about to be a ridiculously fun sniper to use. The Kar 98 got an increased aim down sight speed, small decrease to hip fire spread, and increased damage range. The Mark II carbine got a faster movement speed and increased damage range. The Dragunov got increased aim down sight speed, a 2-hit kill minimum, gun recoil returns to the center more, and a faster rate of fire. So all of these are just getting crazy amounts of love. I know the Kar 98 and Mark II are both marksman rifles, but you can use them effectively as snipers, and with these benefits, I think you're going to enjoy them a little bit more. Let's move on over to our assault rifles. The FAL added a close range damage shelf with one hit headshot potential. So even if you aren't running stopping power, there's still a chance that the FAL at close range can get a one-shot headshot. That is awesome. I know that that sounds crazy. That's one of those weapons you don't want to use at close range, but when it happens, that could be pretty satisfying. The AK-47 got increased aim down sight speed, and the CR-56 AMAX got a decrease to its damage range. Let's move on to the weapon that everyone's been curious about, and that is the Grau 5.56, the weapon that's been absolutely dominating Warzone. So what did they do to snip the balls off this thing? They gave it a damage range reduction, they added more recoil, and on top of that, they changed the Tempest 26-inch barrel and the FSS 20-inch barrel by adding more recoil and, of course, decreasing the overall range on both of those barrels. This weapon, of course, still has the capability of being very valuable, especially at closest to medium ranges, but it definitely is nowhere near what it used to be. Speaking of good weapons, the MP5 also received a nerf. So the 10mm bullet conversion actually got a decrease to its damage range, they reduced the long range damage to that ammo, and they gave a slight recoil increase while using that ammo. And not to mention, they decreased the damage range all across the board just for the MP5 in general, no attachments on that. I think that it was definitely needed. This was one of those submachine guns that could be used as a assault rifle, even in medium to long range engagements. I'm gonna be honest with you, it kind of hurts me inside. Kind of hurts me inside because I like the MP5. It was one of those guilty pleasure weapons, but I can understand why they had to do this. Moving on over to shotgun slugs as an attachment, they got a buff across the board. They increased the projectile velocity, they reduced the aim down sight spread, added dynamic hip spread, increased the damage ranges, and increased the lower torso damage. So you should be getting more one-hit kills from farther distances while using the shotgun slugs. It was one of those attachments that I rarely use, specifically because it was super inaccurate. So I'm gonna have to go back and try them again. Hopefully now with these updates, it'll feel a little bit better. And finally, in the realm of weapons, the no stock attachment got increased weapon recoil, and they decreased the aim down sight aiming steadiness. So that's going to wrap it up for all of the weapon changes. Let's go ahead and talk a little bit about the brand new map, Cheshire Park. That is definitely not how you pronounce that. Cheshire Park. Look, I'm gonna keep it real with you guys. I don't give a fuck. I'm just gonna call it the park. So yeah, throughout this video, you've been seeing gameplay of the new park map, and it's a little bit strange because it's kind of empty in the roads. There are places to camp, there are little corners that you can go to, but that's just a Call of Duty Modern Warfare map. We're kind of used to that type of thing in this game so far. I don't think that it's a terrible map from what small little bit I've been able to play. And since I've only played a very small amount, I don't want to say whether or not this map is good or bad. It's just going to take time. And when I do finally do a review, I'll make sure to give you my full thoughts, and that will probably happen within the next couple of days. So stay tuned for that. I wanted to take a moment to talk about the new sniper, the new anti-material rifle. The cool thing is, this weapon itself is a 50 caliber sniper. But that experimental explosive round actually exists and you're able to apply it. There's also a thermite round if you'd rather use that. Overall though, I noticed that the explosive round travels much slower. It definitely reminds me of the XM25 from Modern Warfare 3, which isn't a bad thing at all. This is going to make for some pretty fun shots in the Warzone experience and of course in Ground War. And I can't wait to just try it out everywhere for the most part. Now, like we said at the beginning of this video, you actually have to do a challenge in order to unlock this sniper in game, but it is completely free. You don't have to purchase it. You don't have to find it in the battle pass. The challenge is to get 3 quick scope kills in 15 different matches. Getting a quick scope in this game is super lenient as well, so it isn't something that you have to be good at. It just happens pretty naturally. And I noticed if you use marksman rifles, that also works as well. So if you're using the SKS and you aim down sight and get a kill very quickly, for some reason that counts as a quick scope kill, so you could do that if you really wanted to. So there is a Lost Souls bundle that's available within the shop if you didn't feel like going through and doing the quick scoping right away and you wanted to just start using the sniper. You can, and you could start unlocking attachments for it and everything of the sort. Unfortunately, you're going to be stuck with the attachments of this particular variant until you actually unlock the sniper itself. But by the time you do that, you should have nearly every single attachment unlocked. I went ahead and picked up the variant for the sake of just getting some gameplay with it, and honestly, it's not too bad. I wish I had a standard sniper scope, but for the most part, it feels pretty good, and of course, the sniper is powerful. I rarely found myself getting a hit marker, and if I did, it was because I shot somebody through a piece of material, but for the most part, every shot that I took was a one-shot kill. The sake of having those extra ammunition choices, it's just for fun, and that's what I like about it, but for the most part, the base version of the Rytec AMR is actually a lot of fun to use. And I'm definitely confident in saying that this is my absolute favorite sniper that's been added to Call of Duty Modern Warfare. It's just a lot of fun to use. Now, of course, since there was an update, a lot of people have been data mining the PC version of the game, and they've been finding some more Intel teasers. You know, those little cards that you'd see when the Intel challenges come through. There's one that says, "The bunkers are opening. It's almost time. The shadows are here. We expected this. And the prisoner? What do we do with him?" Now, this is actually really weird because we've already talked about that weird shadow that was appearing at the dam. Apparently, this has something to do with what's going on within this particular Easter egg, and I have no freaking clue where they plan on taking it. It does kind of sound supernatural in a way, though, so I guess maybe they're going to tie into this next title. Maybe it's going to open up a rift in the dimensions and bring us back to the Cold War, which is how the next Warzone experience gets put into play. I have no freaking clue at this point, but it is very exciting to see this thing developing, finally. Also, within Bunker 11, that secondary bunker now has an accessible keypad, as you can see here in this image. There are even more references to this bunker/nuke event, and even one that says, "I will not die a traitor," and it points towards the bunker that's near the stadium. This one has me flabbergasted. I have no idea what to expect, but it seems like they're playing 3D chess, and they're far ahead of all of us. So let's see what happens. Unfortunately, I can't show you these images, but they were tweeted out by The Gaming Revolution, so I will go ahead and put his Twitter link down below in the description. Go ahead and check out those images. They are very interesting, to say the least. Anyway, guys, that's pretty much it. That's all I wanted to talk about in this particular update here tonight. If you guys enjoyed this video here today, do me a favor, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more coming very soon. And if you haven't yet, please do not forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. Catch y'all in the next one. Peace.